And a good spiritual morning to you once again. I'm Father Cosmas. Thanks for joining me today for a quick chat and our morning cup of coffee. So for today, I wanted to talk about something that I saw in the news recently. This isn't this week, but it was a little while back, and it coordinates with another story that I saw. So recently, I think it was back on the 2nd of the month, October 2nd, we saw that a really important wedding took place in Russia. It's not getting a whole lot of coverage, but basically it would be the equivalent of a royal wedding for Russia, because a Romanov got married. And so George Romanov, I think he's around 40 years old, got married to an Italian woman, Victoria, I want to say Bettarini, if I remember right, and in St. Petersburg. And so it was sort of, you know, this major event, the closest thing that there's been to kind of a royal wedding in Russia in what, a century, maybe more. And so it was this big deal, and it got me thinking about weddings, because I saw another article recently, a couple days ago, in the news, that was talking about, you know, some trends. It was this wedding planner that wrote about, in the last 5 years or so, some of the traditional customs that we've, you know, come to expect with weddings, the ones that are kind of disappearing and aren't, you know, as popular. Let's say that the bride and the groom, they just aren't doing them anymore in the last 5 years. So I thought I would touch upon weddings for today and talk a little bit about some of these trends. And from the point of view of the priest, who gets to see, you know, lots and lots of weddings and gets to attend lots and lots of weddings. And believe me, I've seen quite a bit over the years, over the 25 years that I've been doing this. You get to see lots of interesting and fun choices. Let's call them that. Let's not say mistakes. Let's say choices. I guess I just said mistakes, but choices that are being made by the bride and the groom. And so I thought, well, you know, let's talk about this. This might end up being a two-parter, because I like to try to keep the videos to 5 minutes, but I don't know if I can cover all five things in that short of amount of time. But just to first sort of say, kind of as a sidebar, if there's some sort of an important point to be, you know, gathered from this, or that we can glean from this, you know, not just going through them and having fun with these points, but something really significant for us as Orthodox, as I think about more and more as a priest, we're struggling to get people married in the church. So many people nowadays are not getting married in the church. They're either getting married, you know, civilly outside of the church, destination weddings. What's worse, they're having family members get ordained online. And, you know, perform destination weddings on beaches and parks at hotels. I've gotten requests over the years, you know, to go to a hotel or to a destination and do a service for people. And, you know, we have a struggle of getting people married in the church, first and foremost. And people just, you know, they're choosing not to get married at all. They're just living together for whatever reason. So, one of the things that I wanted to say is that when we have all of these traditions and all these customs, and when there's this long checklist of all of these things that you have to do, I think it does make it a little bit more difficult for people to pull the trigger and actually go through with it. When you have this daunting list of all these things that you have to do, it's easier to say, oh, well, let's just forget about it. Let's just not do it. So I think we have to kind of get back to what's really important. You know, the idea of this Romanov wedding, how amazing it is and how important it is, just significant for the Russian society as just the wedding. The details aren't important. It's more like just it took place. And I think that's what's kind of really important. So let's zip through a couple of these really quick by way of, you know, commentary for me and these five things. And then I'll do maybe the last video, you know, the next video on Thursday on the last three of them. But the first couple that I wanted to touch upon. So number one, some of the little traditions that are kind of falling by the wayside. Let's touch on these kind of quicker. Well, they're not throwing the bouquet and they're not throwing the garter like they used to. And that's falling by the wayside. As you know, you have the groom, the bride sits down in the middle of the dance floor. The groom, you know, takes the garter off, and then all the groomsmen and all the single guys come out, and the groom sort of, you know, throws the garter. And whoever catches it gets to be the pervert, I suppose. I don't know where that's coming from, why you want a part of the bride's undergarments, but that's a tradition that's not happening much anymore. You know, thank God, I'm usually gone by that time at the reception, and people say, Father, why don't you stay to the end? I don't want to see the bride undressed and her underwear, you know, parts of her undergarments flinging through the air. I leave by then. The tossing of the bouquet as well, you know, that the bride turns around and throws it to the bridesmaids or whomever there is a single girl or woman, so that whoever catches it gets to be the one, the next one to get married, supposedly. And so back in the old days, you'd have, you know, bridesmaids kind of elbowing each other and pushing each other out of the way and scrapping and fighting to get the bouquet. Nowadays, I think they're kind of just all sort of taking a step back and watching it fall on the floor so that no one has to get married. Some of these traditions, they're okay to sort of let go, you know, and let's take those boxes off the list so that the bride and groom don't have to check them off and we can get more and more people married as much as we can. I thought I was going to do another one. The video's already going long. People say, do you like practice these videos? No, I do them in one take unless there's a huge problem. So I've already gone longer than I thought. I'm going to end it for this time now, and then I'm going to do the next video on four things, the other four things that, you know, are sort of customs that people just aren't doing anymore that are falling by the wayside. And we'll have some fun with this on Thursday and pick it up from there. So please tune in on Thursday to see the rest of the list. Once again, may our Lord and Savior bless us and keep us this day and every day. Amen.